Use the summation properties and formulas to compute each sum. Notice each sum is expressed using sigma notation. First, we have the sum from p equals 1 to 18 of p squared. If we were to expand this sum, p first takes on the value of 1, so we'd have 1 squared, and then plus p takes on the value of 2, so we have 2 squared, plus p takes on the value of 3, so we have 3 squared, plus 4 squared plus 5 squared and so on, all the way out to plus 18 squared, because the upper limit of the index is 18. So let's write plus dot 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 plus 18 squared. But we want to use a summation formula below to determine the sum. Notice the second formula applies because we have the sum from I equals 1 to n of I squared equals n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1 all divided by 6. Notice in our case, our notation uses the variable p instead of I, but still n, the upper limit of the index is 18, which indicates n equals 18. And therefore the sum is equal to 18 times the sum of 18 and 1 times the quantity 2 times 18 plus 1 all divided by 6. Let's go ahead and simplify. We have 18 times 19 times, 2 times 18 is 36 plus 1 is 37. All divided by 6. Simplifying before multiplying, 18 divided by 6 simplifies to 3. The sum is equal to 3 times 19 times 37, which equals 2,109. For the second example, we have the sum from q equals 1 to 29 of 2q squared. Before we can apply a summation formula, notice the formula here is 2q squared, not just q squared. So we'll use one of our summation properties and write the given sum as 2 times the sum from q equals 1 to 29 of q squared. Focusing on the summation notation, notice n, the upper limit of the index, is 29, which indicates the sum is equal to 2 times, again, we'll use the same formula we used in the first example, which is n times n plus 1 times 2n plus 1, all divided by 6, where now n equals 29. So we have 2 times 29 times the sum of 29 and 1 times the quantity 2 times 29 plus 1, all divided by 6. Simplifying, we have 2 times 29 times 30 times, 2 times 29 is 58 plus 1 is 59, all divided by 6. 30 divided by 6 simplifies to 5. The sum is equal to 2 times 29 times 5 times 59, which equals 17,710. And finally, for the third example, we have the sum from r equals 8 to 39 of r squared. We need to be careful here. Notice the lower limit of the index is r equals 8, not r equals 1, which means in order to evaluate this using a summation formula, we'll have to write this as a difference of two sums. The given sum is equal to the sum from r equals 1 to 39 of r squared minus the sum from r equals 1 to 7 of r squared. Notice the sum from r equals 1 to 39 of r squared has 7 more terms than the original sum that starts at r equals 8, which is why we have to subtract the first 7 terms by subtracting the sum from r equals 1 to 7 of r squared. The difference of these two sums will leave us with the original sum from r equals 8 to 39 of r squared. For the sum from r equals 1 to 39 of r squared, we have n equals 39, which indicates the sum is equal to 39 times the sum of 39 and 1 times the quantity 2 times 39 plus 1, all divided by 6, and then minus, for the sum from r equals 1 to 7 of r squared, now n is 7, and therefore the sum is 7 times the sum of 7 and 1 times the quantity 2 times 7 plus 1, all divided by 6. Simplifying, we have 39 times 40 times 79, all divided by 6, minus 7 times 8 times 15, divided by 6. And again, simplifying, 39 is equal to 3 times 13, which indicates 39 and 6 share a common factor of 3. There are 13 3s in 39 and 2 3s in 6. And then 40 divided by 2 simplifies to 20. And then for the second quotient, 8 and 6 share a common factor of 2. There are 4 2s in 8, 3 2s in 6. And 15 divided by 3 simplifies to 5. The sum is equal to 13 times 20 times 79, and then minus 7 times 4 times 5, which equals 20,400, which again is the sum from r equals 8 to 39 of r squared. I hope you found this helpful.